some level of really stellar play away from home, because the NCAA looks at that, right? They look, are you going to be able to travel?
There's the nitty-gritty point.
Are you going to be able to go on the road and travel? Okay, great, you have great fans. These fans like to travel with you. But can you, as a team, perform on the road? Because we're not going to give you that benefit of the doubt. If you end up as a bubble team, or if you end up, we're not going to give you that benefit of the doubt unless you can show us that you can go to another gym and you can play the way you play at home.
Yeah, that is the nitty-gritty point, because right now the Bulls are definitely not an NCAA tournament team just because of their experience in Cancun, where they played three good teams, lost to all of them, and unfortunately we've seen since. Now, FGCU is the exception, but South Dakota State has lost a few games since then. They got beat yesterday. Notre Dame has not gotten back on the winning track. Simply put, the Bulls didn't have their game together, when if you step back and look at those exact three teams, I think FGCU would still be a toss-up. But really, right now, the way the Bulls have turned it around, I think they'd go 2-1 for sure, but they didn't when they played them.
I agree. That was a problem, and that Texas win at home might turn out to be not as spectacular as we thought it might be. It depends how Texas performs in the Big 12 this year. So it's a really dicey season. But they obviously need to perform today. They need to beat this Idaho team and then get out to the desert and really do a nice job out there.
And that's the whole point. Definitely want to take care of these. You worry about that. That is not going to hurt your RPIs. The team that last year made it to the third round of the WNIT, one round beyond where the Bulls made it, but they lost their top two pieces. They called them the Splash Sisters, Michaela Ferenc and Taylor Pierce. All Taylor Pierce did was set a Division I single season record for most made threes with 154, and they were able to replace that scoring.
About that, with Kelsey Plum having been out there in the world in Division One, and yep, some really great shooters before her, obviously. But I mean, that's a pretty big statistic.
So that's what they lost, and they did have and bring back, of course, now as a sophomore, the freshman of the year in the Big Sky Conference, in Gina Markson, and she has led them in scoring. She averages 13.5 points a game. She is their top 3-point shooter. Markson, Marksman, makes sense. 19 for 63, not a bad percentage. And then after her, what a great story she is. Beyonce B, which looks like Beyonce Bia, but we'll pronounce it properly. And she is a tremendous story. She has been second on the team in scoring with around 12 points a game and top rebounding in 7.3. And I looked into more of her story. All she did last year as a senior in high school at Washougal High School in Washington was lead the school to their first state championship, scoring 30 in the finals while she was being the valedictorian of the school. Other than that,
what else? What have you done lately?
Not that special of a player. Lizzie Klinker and her sister Natalie, both from the state of Montana. Lizzie started off at Utah State. She transferred back in, so you have the sisters also in the starting lineup. And a surprise member of the starting lineup today, Chase Milne, a guard from Hawaii. But for the most part, as you would imagine, the Idaho roster made up of folks from Idaho and Washington. A couple of exceptions were freshmen from Australia. Of course, we'll tell you more about their starting lineup when we get closer to the tip. It looks like, of course, with no Elisa Pinzon, we're going to see Maria Alvarez at the point, Elena Chinecki, and Anna Pahajic probably slide into the starting lineup. Beatrice Jordal will no doubt be out there as well. We'll have Jose Fernandez coming up next. This is Women's Basketball on USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon. Thank you. Thank you.
Here.
some tape. I don't need tape.
You don't.
We're
giving
this back, I think.
You good?
Yeah.
You feeling me over there?
I hear you.
Check. You got me? Nothing over there. Check. Check. Alrighty. Check.
Put it out on Twitter about the 4-6. I wanted to wait until it aired before I mentioned it. The Christmas outfits always go over well.
Oh, yeah.
I would have worn a red tie if I had one. I do not have one. I feel poorly about that. USF has not lost at the Yingling Center. The Bulls are 6-4 going up against an Idaho team that is 4-3. Started off the season with a loss at Oklahoma State. Turned around and beat a Colorado State that was 3-1 at the time. Then went to the other USF, so they kind of feel like they're doing well so far at USF. Okay. San Francisco grabbed a win there and then got to 3-1 on the season with a 90-point performance at Seattle U in overtime. In that game, Gina Markson, who again is their leading scorer, freshman of the year last year in the Big Sky, had 30 points, and had 27 points in that game. But after going to 3-1, they would drop a mysterious result at Lamar. They led in that game 8-0, and then were up at the half, but couldn't do much after that. Old Dominion also at that same event where they lost to Lamar out in St. Louis Obispo. They fell in that game back to 500, but in their most recent game at San Diego, so a little bit of a road trip from there to here, they got back above 500, and their win was 65-32. That's the fewest points they've allowed to, second fewest they've allowed to a Division I team. And that seems to be the key of this team. They're focused on their defense. With that in mind, we'll see if the Bulls can even come close to their last three-point shooting performance without their point guard, as the first jump ball is going to be reset here with no Elisa Pinzon, but I'm guessing it'll be Maria Alvarez running the point with Elena Chenecki on the wing. find out soon. Anna Pahadges, the big three-point shooter. Underneath Tamara Henshaw and Beatrice Jordow. We already talked about Markson and B, the two leaders for Idaho. The Klinker sisters, Lizzie and Natalie, both from the state of Montana, and Chase Milne round out the starting lineup. The Bulls win the tap, going from our right to our left, and it will be Maria Alvarez running the point for USF. Off to Chinecki, who loves to drive to the hoop, and that was good to see, and a foul right off the bat, something that Jose Fernandez has spoke about, not being able to draw enough fouls, and that's maybe an early sign that's what they're going to try and do.
It is, but Idaho giving a gift, being in man-to-man defense. Bulls have not seen a lot of man-to-man defense this year. It's a lot easier to draw a foul if you're a person who likes to drive.
On the underneath inbounds pass, we're so used to seeing Eliza Pinzon, who, if you were not tuned into our pregame, will be out somewhere 4 to 6 weeks. She got hurt late in the last game here when the Bulls were able to win the game, but lose the, of course, services of their point guard and their power forward, Betty Benunga. Her injury not nearly as long-term, it would appear. Idaho, good defense on the inbounds pass. It forces up a tough jumper by Anna Pahadzic, and pulling down the rebound is Natalie Klinker. Gina Markson again runs the point. She led them in assists last year as a freshman and leading them with around 4 assists per game while also being able to be their leading three-point shooter. Bulls playing man-to-man on her. They jump it off to B, who is not necessarily known as a three-point shooter. She drops it down. It's 3-0. Beyonce B, 10 of 26, more known for her underneath skills as their leading rebounder, but showed nice touch there.
She did. That was a swish right out of the box.
Idaho with the black jerseys and the gold numbers. Badges for a three to look to even things up. She was flowing off that shot, missed it, but Tamara Henshaw gets the rebound and going to earn a trip to the free throw line as she was fouled on the putback attempt.
Henshaw picking up where she left off. 15 rebounds in the last game. It was nice to see her keep the ball high and try and get it back up, muscle it back up. That's how you're going to get the foul called down there and get yourself back to the free throw line.
B, who in her first game as a freshman picked up 10 rebounds against Oklahoma State, and again, is as Tamara Henshaw makes the first free throw, 3-1 is the score now. You toss out basically her low game. I wish you could do this for everybody, right? She's averaging 14-8 per game, and she's off to a quick start here with that three-pointer. Henshaw clanks that one short. Jordow tried to keep it alive, but pulling down the ball is Chase Milne. Now it's over to Lizzie Klinker. Again, she is the older of the two Klinker sisters. She's the one that started off at Utah State. She is a wing, whereas Natalie Klinker, you're going to see her underneath. Lizzie the wing out to her sister. Natalie tries to drive in and gets stopped by Henshaw, blocks the shot, but right back to Natalie Klinker for an easy putback. It's 5-1. 8:42 to go, just underway here. Idaho off to the quick start. Maria Alvarez drives in, lane opens up. Padgett calls for the ball, gets the ball, and misses the three-point shot. Not due to defense, we should point that out. She was wide open on that shot. Goes out of bounds, Vandals ball.
Yeah, Bulls struggling a little bit from the three-point line there. They did not understand, I think, that Idaho was in a zone right there. Looked like Idaho fell back into a zone on that. Bulls playing, setting up in their man-to-man offense.
Idaho allowing its opponents just 19.5% from three-point shots, but that was a wide-open look. Markson's going to put it up, and she is their three-point shooter, and she drills it. So Idaho jumps ahead of the Bulls 8-1.
Markson, a great-looking point guard, right? Very nimble. She looks very nimble, quick crossover right there.
From Salmonish, Washington, Chinecki being marked well. That's a tough shot, and she misses it. Henshaw pulls down the rebound and can't make the follow-through, and that is follow-up, and that's been something that has marked the Bulls this year, the inability to put back putbacks, as it were, and it's a tie-up on the rebound. It'll be Idaho ball.
That was a great get by Tamara Henshaw. She still needs to gather herself, though, right? She is putting it back up quickly, which is very good. She's not trying to take the power dribble, but you do have to gather yourself and not fall away. Go to the hoop.
Bulls have missed their first five shots. Idaho 3-for-4, including a couple of three mades. They get a screen for Marks, and they got to watch out for her. You're right. She looks very fluid out there. Gets another screen from Natalie Klinker. They throw it around to B, and boy, the very tall B looks pretty smooth on the drive there, but misses the shot. Bulls get the rebound with Henshaw back to where she was the other day, just racking up the rebounds. Already has a couple in this game. Maria Alvarez dumps it off to Anna Pahadzic. They jump out on her over to Henshaw. She's not going to shoot from where she is, top of the key. Chinecki gets a screen from Jordow, a long jumper, and she knocks it down. Great shot by Chinecki. Jordow, the half assist with the screen, and the first field goal make about 2.5 minutes into the game, but it's 8-3 Idaho.
Great timing by Chinecki there, waiting on Jordow to get set and then using the screen.
Chase Milne getting the start, but we anticipate seeing a couple of other scoring options for Idaho. There are the big four are out there. Markson, yeah, over to Milne. She passes that up right away into the corner, and this could be a four-point trip. Yeah, it's a made three by Lizzie Klinker, and a foul underneath. Basket is good, and it's a three-point basket. Add the foul on the Bulls, Beatrice Jordan. It's 11-3.
Interesting, Klinker, great looking shot there from the corner.
And it'll be ball underneath.
Yeah, it was on Beatrice Jordan. There's a rebounding foul there. Jordan has had some foul trouble this season, so something to keep an eye on.
Lizzie just 3 of 14. They get it underneath, and they get another quick basket, and there's a timeout. 13-3, Idaho is here and ready to go, and the Bulls, well, they got to talk about it. 6:52 to go in the first quarter, Bulls down 10. This is women's basketball in USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon.
I'm sure they'll miss at some point.
How's the mix sound back there, Blake? Blake? How's it sound back there? Good answer.
Not good.
They look awful.
Not good.
Nope.
The Florida Lottery has contributed more than $33 billion to support education. Your ticket purchase helps Florida students have a brighter future. Follow at on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. We play barely more than 3 minutes, and is off to as hot of a start as you could get right now, leading the Bulls 13-3.
Yeah, shooting 71% from the field, 3 for 3 from 3-point line. They are getting a hand in their face, but the intensity is lacking in the Bulls defense. They're getting there, but not with the intensity that I think Coach Fernandez and his staff would like to see on the offensive side of things. The Bulls look a little bit disjointed, shooting around 60% from the now 1 for 6.
I think they were taken back with that B three-pointer to get things going. Again, she is a 6-foot-1 player that is their leading rebounder when she's hitting threes, and then just had a 5-point trip, which can also set you back. Let's see if the Bulls can get it back going. Padgett fakes the open three. Actually, she was guarded well, gets a closer look and misses it badly. Chinecki gets the rebound with 8 on the shot clock. Alvarez runs in, and there must be a little bit of a wardrobe malfunction, so it's going to be Padgett's checking out, and she was going to come out anyway for Brabi. And they're going to say with 2 o'clock rebound. It didn't hit the rim, though. I think that it was a shot clock situation, so they had to reset the shot clock at 17.
Did it scrape the rim?
If it did, boy, we didn't see it. So the Bulls get an extra 10 seconds there and a substitution with Brabi in, and she had a great game last time out. 10 on the shot clock she has. It gets a screen from Jordan and too much of a screen, and Bia looks over at the coach to say, was that a foul? It absolutely was. She held out her arms, and now she is going to come out of the game. So with 6:21 to go in the first quarter, Bulls a little bit shaky, down 13-3. You got to think that Idaho is going to start missing some shots, but the Bulls need to
foul trouble.
Unnecessary fouls. Again, yeah. That goes down to the turnover as well. Markson, I thought, was fouled there. Barely misses the shot, so kind of a break there that it's not a 12-point game, in my opinion. Maria Alvarez pushes it up to Brabi. They try and drive the lane, but Chinecki's pass is intercepted. Great work by Shea Leverett, and she throws it, I think, off of an Idaho player. Let's see whose ball it is. No, it's going to be Idaho ball. Off line. Chased it down into the corner and going out of bounds, tried to throw it off an Idaho player, but it went
straight down instead.
What we anticipated here with Pinzon being injured, Bold relying on young guards here to get the offense moving. So Alvarez at the point, Chinecki at the two, and Brabenceva at the three.
B has it out with Bobby on her to Markson, who's already made a three. And Maria Alvarez switches on to her. They throw it inside to the taller Clinker, the younger Clinker sister. Man-to-man defense with Alvarez out to mark. Six on the shot clock. Long three is off the mark. And they'll let Milne shoot all day long. Chinecki pulls the rebound down. 5.5 minutes to go first quarter. Pulls down 13-3. Chinecki trap trying to drive baseline. Alvarez out front. Swings it around to Brabi. They go inside to Shea. Swings it over to Alvarez, but they jump out on. Shot fakes the long two. Hands it off to Alvarez with 10 on the shot clock. Good defense on the perimeter by the Vandals. So driving in becomes an option for Brabi, and she misses the shot. I think she just got fouled.
Oh, yeah, they
got
to call that.
They're going to call that on Brabi, even though she got whacked in the head.
You can't.
And the crowd doesn't like that at all.
No, I disagree. If that
and they are going to actually look at it because originally the foul was called on Brabi for a position on the court, but if it's an elbow, that's something they can look at on.
That's a.
On Brabi.
The Bulls fans are going to go crazy on
and
this.
At the same time, though, they're going to look at a replay. Very interesting.
The pass time down, Bulls putting Brabi out there on B. And that is important because she's a tall player. Brabi. Shots.
First two misses was followed up immediately by a score. Bulls, meanwhile, just the one make by Elena Chinecki. 1-for-8 from the floor, 0-for-2 on threes. You had a that it was going to be a little bit different to come by the scoring, but what we didn't anticipate efficient on their end. Okay, they're going to jump out here, and it looks like Idaho is settling back on defense, expecting this to be a perhaps a call. We'll give it to you against
both
them.
Yeah,
I know. They're not sure what's going to happen. Remember, right now you can get 5 cents off while we're waiting. A reminder, 5 cents off every gallon of fuel every day with Make It Count rewards from Marathon. To sign up, just visit makeitcount.com/radio or download the free app. Offer valid only at participating Marathon locations. Marathon, fueling the American spirit. This conference comes to a head at the center of the court. The decision has been made, and if there's a decision right now, that means there is definitely an elbow, because if there was no ruling on an elbow, they wouldn't be talking right now.
Right, and I'm trying to think back through my women's basketball rules, which have changed recently on the failing elbows. And a failing elbow, if that's considered a technical. And when it's at the face like that, it was that needed to be called.
Just to give a visual, every time Bridget speaks about the elbow, she puts her elbow in my face, and I'm going to catch one of her failing elbows. But
you know, you got to know that that hurts. Anyone who's ever been hit in the face.
All right, we're going to get a. I'm going to try and lend my ear. It is a
flagrant. Intentional, nice.
Wow, intentional. Now the question here does it become? Do they wave off the foul by Brabi? I don't see how you can have an intentional foul on one player and call a foul on the other player at the very same time.
So that's going to be probably flagrant one, right?
Yep. John Newley is calling, the Idaho coach is being called with Jose Fernandez for a discussion here. Flagrant foul level one. I just read his lips. And Coach Newley, the Idaho coach, is not exactly protesting. He's just taking it all in.
Coach Newley's getting two shots on free throw line.
There you have it. And can Brabi see? And they are going to call it on the player, Natalie Clinker. So we will see if the foul gets removed from Brabi. I don't think that. Nickel free throws here and ball. So that's a good sign. Elena Chinecki, hopefully a good time for Brabi to take all that pain and turn it into maybe 2 points, because she definitely deserved it.
Oh, that was that was hurt.
Chinecki, who is, wait till this free throw goes, very good at the free throw line this year. Team, leading the team in that category.
getting her fourth start. That one looked good. It is. So she makes both. It'll be Bulls ball. So this quarter to Brabi. So game, and that was actually.
As she came out. Yeah, they took her out just now. So
big turnaround into the game is Isabel Haddon. So that could be a huge moment in this game. 13-5, less than five to go here in the first quarter. Bulls trying to come back from down 10. Henshaw gets the ball in against a lesser defender. Misses the wide open layup, however. And that's something that, again, plagued the Bulls in Cancun, Mexico, the simple inability to finish. That's not going to block the shot.
It's surprising. It's her left side, her strong side for Henshaw. She's a left-handed player, so really surprising miss there. She kind of went over the rim.
Haddon gets the ball, puts it up immediately. And Idaho continues its hot streak. It's 15-5, so Haddon right off the bench puts one down. So the Bulls have missed a couple of layups along with going 0 of 2 on 3s. Alvarez inside to Brabi, out to Chinecki for a wide open 3. That looks good, but a little bit long. Fight for the rebound. Looks like Shea Leverett's going to win it, and she does. Gets it out to Brabi. A reset with Chinecki now handling the ball, but Maria Alvarez still in there off to the wing. Maybe they're going to try and get her open. Double screen for Chinecki, but Idaho reads it. Chinecki's going to try and drive, changes hands, nothing there. Leverett fights for the rebound, has to go up with it, and gets fouled. Couldn't put it back, but the Bulls with a chance to go to the free throw line. They missed their last five field goals, but they're down 10, still in it.
I'll tell you, the Bulls are experiencing a lot of physicality down low from the Idaho post players. They are extremely physical, and I think that's unanticipated by how they look. They're not particularly big or bulky post players at all.
You know, I mentioned that. And that's not to disparage. Sure, as Lever makes the first. Not making their threes, but making their free throws. And after this next one, which is Daniel here, another reception for. She gets a chance. She will right now if the free throw goes down, but it's no good. And the horn situation, they'll wave it off, and it's Bulls ball. And I mentioned Haddon was their leading shot blocker the last two seasons, even though she only had one in their last nine games last year, so I don't want to disparage her as a defender. 10 seconds to go. Pulls down the rebound and gets fouled. That is going to be a trip to the free throw line as it's the fifth foul of the quarter and will lead to Sydney Harvey. Check.
I know she passed it to Chinecki, but she was in the corner. I'm not sure what she was going to do with it with a couple defenders on it.
And the crowd recognizing Sydney Harvey into the game for the first time this season. Freshman who was so outstanding for the team last year took over the reins as the starting point guard. It's kind of a role reversal. Henshaw's first free throw, good, 15-7. Last year, of course, it was Harvey getting had a minor injury, and it was time for Pinzon to come in. And Pinzon, it's a 15-8 game. It's a struggle as it's. Traveling. That Jose Fernandez has been stressing goes off.
Time to set. It's not, you know, it's a double screen.
15-8, 3 minutes to go, first quarter. They run a couple of nice screens for Markson, and that.
Harvey, a lot of. That's what she brings here.
by Sydney.
Well, we alluded to it earlier, a role reversal with Wolves not getting much lately at the line compared to just 1 of 12 from the floor. While Idaho has not attempted a free throw, but has made 7-11 for Wolves, allowing them to hang in today. It's 18-10.
Sure, get the points however you can get when the shots aren't falling.
And then when the three hopefully start falling, but again, this Vandals team does not come up often. Haddon misses that open jumper, same she made the other one. Now the Bulls want to run with the ball. That's something that Coach Fernandez spoke about in transition. Harvey up to Alvarez, and she runs over, and she'll get a blocking call against the older Klinker sister, Lizzie Klinker. So the Klinkers have been called for a combined 5 fouls.
And, you know, you'd like to see Alvarez maybe take that. I know that's part of the fast break for the Bulls to drive that lane and pass it to the opposite.
The year, by the way, yeah, the Idaho opponents have made about 50 more total.
Okay, so they
and it's been the other way around for the Bulls, essentially. Their opponents have made, looking out for the Bulls, or Alvarez sinks two more.
It for sure is, and this is Alvarez's natural spot, I think, on this team is to be a two, so it's good to have Harvey in there relieving that point guard duty from her.
I think you're right on the money there. B misses a driving shot. It's 18-12 with 2.5. Drops it off to Alvarez, drops it underneath the left. A load of blocks in her first three seasons now at Idaho. She grabs one there. Markson falling away, actually misses that three. Now 2 minutes to go. They want to push Harvey up to Alvarez. Back to Sydney Harvey. Great to see her. Use her. That'd be the screen by Leverett. Pulls up for a jumper. They hadn't made a field goal, but now with that jumper by Sid, it's a four-point game.
I know.
It's nice.
Well,
to
I could have just
Sydney
said
Harvey
that and been just
too.
As accurate to see her back out there. And again, with losing pins on. Now, they're saying that Harvey's only needing a couple minutes at a time, but she looks like she could play more than that. And there's a shuffle of the feet. It was Haley Christopher who has had a big-time struggle this year turning it over.
And Coach Fernandez just said to Harvey, you okay? You all right out there? She said, yeah, I'm good. So I think he's going to try and leave her into the court, or at least maybe take 30 seconds left. A little extra break.
So Alvarez comes out for the first time, and you're right. Harvey, looking good, stays in there. And it's Henshaw checking in for the Bulls. Out to Henshaw, thought about a long three drives, instead got out of. Than the Bulls this year, so this is a good turnaround. There's a long three. We mentioned the struggling. From three this year, a 19% field goal shooter, and with that make by Christopher, it becomes a seven-point game again. So Idaho gets a little momentum back. Harvey looks to get it right back for the Bulls, and she's driving the lane and scores two straight makes for Sydney. I think she's back, everybody. She's leading the team with 6 points.
Oh, it's good to see her back. She looks a little bit winded now, but she is hanging in there.
She had to practice during Heck Week. And if she had to practice during that very much
could
difficult
help.
Week, yeah, there's a foul against Henshaw. She pounds the court. She might want to watch out for the reaction there. She's going to send Idaho to the free throw line for the first time. But Harvey, I should say, some extra playing time here.
Had great help there. She got called for the foul, but she came over. Most players had to switch on some screen. Henshaw was there for help side.
Oh, with the two starting post players, two fouls apiece, but it's worth noting. Okay, they've taken one of the fouls and taken it from being a personal foul to just a technical on the other Klinker, I suppose. So the two Klinker sisters, both with two each for Idaho. So no one has fouls yet. 22-16 as Idaho makes.
hot do you think that is?
All right. Got it. Bulls win, you win at Papa John's. The day after a USF win, get 50% off pizzas online or on the app. Just use the promo code USFWINS. Plus, track your order to the door with the new Papa John's tracker. Papa John's, proud supporter of USF. Well, role reversal. Bulls are the team hitting the free throws. Opponent is the team hitting the three-point shots. But it adds up with, of course, those three-pointers generally counting for more than free throws, 23-16 Vandals.
You know, Idaho coming in shooting just 26% from the three-point line. So it's pretty stunning to see them. I understand why Bulls might have been a step slow in this first quarter getting out there because you just don't believe it. But now it's time to believe it. They got to get out there with a little bit more urgency, hands high. I just don't think that Idaho's going to beat them on the drive. And help side for the Bulls is great. Their defensive rotation is great. So they should go out there with a little bit more urgency and start to kind of dissuade the three-point shooting.
Yeah, you give Haley Christopher the open shot. Again, was just 3 for 27. That first one by Beyonce B, again, is their more inside player. And so that kind of led to the avalanche of threes. But Gina Markson has been there all year, and she's made a couple for them. Elena Chenecki drives in. You could tell they wanted to get it right underneath the Shea Leverett, but she telegraphed the pass, and Idaho gets it to start off the second quarter after the Bulls turn it over. It's 23-16, Vandals. Couple of Idaho players with two fouls, the Klinker sisters, two of their starters, and the two starting posts for the Bulls, Henshaw and Jordal, both with two fouls. So Leverett underneath, Christine Bermejo into the game. Good defense by the Bulls, much better here. They get it open to B on the left side. That three is short. Again, you expect that when you give her the ball there. Pahadzic, Brabi, and Chenecki, along with Bermejo and Leverett. Chenecki is running the point right now. Sydney Harvey gave the Bulls a big lift with 6 points off the bench. Bermejo has it. Has a chance to drive in, looks for somebody to give it to. There's a great bounce pass to Shea Leverett. Boy, you could see that she was waiting for that cut by Shea, and she gave it to her. It's a 5-point game.
Yeah, she waited that 1-1000, 2-1000. You're kind of like, get it to her, but Shea made that cut at the right time.
It looks like she was being indecisive, but really in her head, she knew what she was doing all along. Markson knows what she's doing, but misses that three, so the Vandals are starting to cool off a little bit. Bulls, mind you, yet to make one. Bulls get the rebound. They are leading in that category, 15-9. Hatchett over to Chenecki. Markson guards her pretty well. Chenecki drives it again to Leverett. Gets a power dribble and scores! And is fouled! Way to go, Shea Leverett. Bulls are within 3 points with a chance to make it two.
Good look by Chenecki. Great catch by Leverett on the move. And then to go up strong, gather herself and grow up strong. So Bulls starting to look a little bit better on offense here, getting used to maybe the pace, or, you know, they had played for a little bit, but just kind of settling in.
Well, the drives and the dump-offs, and I think that was obviously the message in the first quarter break there, is they tried to do it on the first possession, didn't work out, but it's worked out great on these last two. And Shea Leverett completes a three-point play, really starting to get that three-throw percentage back up after going 0-for-7 to start off the season. She is at a much better number right now, 3-for-4 today. She has, by my count, made 8 of her last 10. My count could be off, but it's still really a good turnaround. 23-21, Idaho puts up another three and banks it in. At worst, Caitlin Jones flops down to the court looking for a bank shot and 1-3, but they'll get the three. Lucky, 26-21. Caitlin Jones does average 7 points a game, and that here's her game, by the way. She just basically shoots three-pointers. And that is Chenecki's game, but she misses the driving layup, gets it back.
Oh, no.
Can't follow through.
Sorry.
Ball's bounded up in the air, and Leverett wins it. And gets a one round of applause there by the crowd here at the Yuengling Center. 2 minutes gone, second quarter. Bulls down 26-21 after that fortunate break. Bermejo that time fakes the pass and lays it in. Christina Bermejo
1 for 11 to start off the year, but you can see her becoming comfortable and gets a reward back to a three-point game.
Really nice fake in the lane to Leverett, which the Vandals are worried about because she's had that pass to Leverett a couple times down now.
Bulls have got to watch out for Caitlin Jones. She comes off a screen and drops a three and pumps her fist, and that's the way to do it. When you get a lucky bank shot to come down and swish it back in, she is a freshman from Perth, Australia, and basically all of her shots are three-pointers, and they were calling for her to be the careful person there. And she makes it anyway. Bermejo misses the rebound. Bulls down six after they had cut it to two on the back-to-back threes by Caitlin Jones. Now can the Bulls get their first three? They are 0 for 5. Idaho 7 for 11. 7 on the shot clock. Pahatchis lunts a screen. Needs to make this one. It's up, and it's no good. Shea Leverett wins the rebound. It'll be Bulls ball underneath.
You know, Shea Leverett averages over 6.5 rebounds a game. Most of her rebounds this season are offensive in nature. So she's had about, coming into the game, 40 offensive rebounds to the 26 defensive rebounds. So she is a force to be reckoned with.
11 offensive rebounds for the Bulls, 3 offensive for Henshaw. Underneath the basket, 6:55 to go first half. After all the made threes by Idaho, the Bulls are still down by 6, considering they haven't made one. That's a big deal. Pahadges, another open three. That looked better, and it's no good. And another fight for the rebound. Shea Leverett, boy, she is playing with abandon. Not reckless either. Alvarez swings it over to Pahadges. She's going to put up a long two and misses that one. Brobbie gets the rebound. Out to Alvarez for a wide open three, and it's no good. But Brobbie with the rebound. This is crazy. Bulls getting every rebound. Now can Bermejo knock it down? No! 4 missed threes on this possession. And boy, Idaho has that number of field goal defense on threes, but none of those were defended. They were wide open misses. 0 for 9 to start off the game from 3.
You know, not quite sure what that is. They were good looks, really good looks. Bulls doing a great job on the boards. They've got to hit one of those.
It's going to take one. And I thought, well, 4 times it was going to happen. That shot gets tipped. They knew that they were going to go right to Jones, and Leverett was ready for it. Boy, it's just going to take one made three. Out to Bermejo, wants to drive in, and she gets fouled. That'll be the second foul of the quarter. We played a little bit less than 4 minutes. Bulls down by 6, so they had 4 chances from 3 there. Offensive rebounds favoring USF 14-1, but the second chance points just 6-2.
You know, but Bulls, you cannot, there's nothing to criticize on that.
Not
you know,
at
when
all.
You're not having a great shooting night, it's good that you're rebounding.
The efforts, obviously, they are on the rebound, and I can tell you they're not trying to miss the threes. 4 minutes gone in the second quarter. Bulls within 6 after this wild sort of give and go that's been happening. And there's another good pass by Brobbie to Leverett. Makes the layup. Shea Leverett, ladies and gentlemen, up to 8 points already, leading the way, and the Bulls back to within 4.
You know what, the freshman guards, I think, each at least have one assist. They're doing a really nice job passing interior to the post.
B, far away from the basket. There's Jones, and they pop out on her. They're not going to let her get off an easy shot. Boy, a long three, and it's no good. But that time it looked like Idaho did have position. Haddon wins the rebound. Out to Jones. Boy, she only shoots threes. This time she drives in, as I'm saying it, out to B for an open three. Looks short, and it is. Great blocking out by the Bulls. Brobbie, I saw, but Bermejo gets the rebound. Back to within 4, and the ball as we near the midway point of the second quarter. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bulls are 25% from the floor. 0 for 9 on threes, while their opponent has made 7 threes in 14 tries, and yet it's still just a 4-point margin. They've been going inside to Shea Leverett. She pops out here. Right at the midway point, 10 on the shot clock. Maria Alvarez fakes the three, sees a cutting Brobbie, and she is going to travel.
Yeah.
And the Bulls, maybe one pass too many there. We'll go to a break with 4:54 to go in the half. Idaho 29, USF 25. This is women's basketball and USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon. You're going to have 90 seconds at the end of the – you can take it down to 90 at the end of the half.
Okay.
Elon is hanging around with NC State. That's a little surprising.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they're below 500. Kentucky's winning.
Okay. USF Athletics. Greg, you can come back now. Greg is not a quitter. How about the noise for Greg? He is not giving up on this contest. Come on back, Greg.
When traveling to see the USF Bulls, start with a fill-up at Marathon, and to make it a winning trip, go to mileshavemeaning.com. Marathon, fueling the American spirit. Well, if you're just, of course, you're listening to us right now, but if you were just looking at the box score and you saw that the USF Bulls were 0 of 9 on three-pointers, and you knew that Idaho was leading the country in three-point percentage defense, you would think, well, there you go. They're just all up in the Bulls' face. Not really. They prevented some shots from going up, but in the end, the Bulls have worked their way into open shots. They just haven't made one yet, and that's why they're losing 29-25.
But it's only 29-25, and not only have they not made a three, they're only shooting 25% from the field. So really good work on the free throw line, where they're about 85%. So Bulls hanging in there. I really think Bulls have done a great job playing defense. I think putting Verbensova on B has bothered me a little bit so far because of the size and length of Verbensova.
Speaking about Beyonce, B, who is a big freshman for Idaho, tremendous high school player, and already well into her college career. She's going to be a doctor, by the way, just one of those really, really impressive players. Markson been very impressive as a point guard. Bermejo knocks it away. It'll still be Idaho ball, but getting her hand in there and earning some extra minutes here.
She's done a great job on the offensive end, passing, driving, making the defense player, and they actually have her on B right now, which is probably also good. She and Brabenska are switching back and forth.
10 on the shot clock, 4.5 in the first half. Bulls trail at 29-25. Markson away from the basket. And good cutoff there by Alvarez. There's Haddon. They want to drop it off to Markson with two. Haddon's going to have to put up a jumper. Actually, looks pretty good, and it is. Makes the shot, and you're hearing, oh, no, as Shea Leverett might have. She went down, but she's going to pop back up, and that's a good note. And looks like she's probably going to stay in the game. Now, they just said no shot because the score's staying at 29-25. I did not see a foul call there. Now, if they're saying the shot didn't get off before, oh, they're going to check to see if it got off before the buzzer. I'm pretty sure it did.
Sorry, I was just watching Leverett. She looks okay. She said she can stay on the floor.
So Haddon, who made that shot, came into the game just averaging 5 points, but looks pretty good today, actually.
They left it.
And they did count the basket by Haddon, so she makes another field goal. Which is what she does, basically. She scores two field goals every game, except for one game where she put in five against Colorado State. And then she was held without one last time around. So she's come in for one of the injured Klinker sisters. That would be injured in foul trouble, I should say. Lizzie Klinker, and done a nice job for Idaho. So they've gotten some good contributions off the bench and back up to a six-point lead. Robbie underneath. Pass was knocked away, intended for Bermejo. It'll still be Bulls ball underneath.
And Coach Fernandez yelling at Brabi to shoot the ball, and I agree. Boy, I agree. I know she's a great passer, but she needs to shoot on that layup. She's really long, and she can get up and above them.
Can this be a first three? Nope, it rims out by Maria. Looked good all the way. 4 minutes to go in the first half. Bulls now 0 for 10, and another wide-open three that does not go down. They missed six in this quarter. Pardon me, five. Feels like six. Feels like more than six. 3:48 to go in it. Jones puts it right up, and that one is a little bit too long. Shea Leverett grabs her fifth rebound, which seems like she's got about 50.
It does feel like she's got a lot of rebounds.
Pajic guarded well that time by Haley Christopher. Out to Brabi. Bring it back out to Maria Alvarez. Drives. Knocked off her path at the free throw line.
You know we're going to hear at halftime, Derek, a lot of dribbling. Too much dribbling.
Brabi goes up for a long jumper as ordered, and it goes nothing but air and out of bounds. Padgett couldn't quite handle it, so the Bulls down six. Idaho ball with 3:21 to go in the half.
And that's not the shot Coach Fernandez wanted her to take. He wants her to take it to the hoop, get herself to the free throw line. But there is a lot of dribbling, as well as the Bulls came out in that second quarter, the start of the second quarter. Now it's very stagnant because there's a lot of dribbling.
Janie King into the game for the first time, and she is another one of their designated shooters, so the Bulls have got to watch out as she posts up in the corner. Markson, the point guard, with the ball out to Haddon, who's just had a fire gunslinging mentality out there, makes her third shot. It's now 33-25. Idaho playing with no fear, no hesitation, kind of a nothing to lose sort of situation for them, while the Bulls just can't quite get the shots to fall. There's Bermejo for a three on cue.
She puts it up and makes her first three as a Bull, and the first three of the day, very welcomed, 33-28.
Very good. Good job getting the Bulls out of that drought and showing some confidence taking that three.
She checked in at least 4 minutes ago. Markson drives in, puts it up, and it rolls out. Break for the Bulls. Now can they chase it down? They can. It'll be Idaho ball. It's a five-point game, 2.5 minutes to go in the first half. Yeah, Bermejo checked in late first quarter, and yeah, she has not checked out since.
Her length is very important here because Idaho does have some long players who like to shoot threes.
And this is a pretty significant development for Mayho, and you're right, playing a lot of defense. Told you about the three-point shooter, and she misses that one, Janie King. Now the Bulls try to cut it back underneath. Less than five, which is where it is right now. Bermejo, all sorts of confidence. Oh, her layup was affected there by Haddon and just missed, but loving what we're seeing either way.
Yes,
Markson, there's
look.
King. Thinks about a three, puts up a long one, looks off to the right, and it is. Boy, Idaho, you can tell this is a three-point shooting-based offense. And not afraid to put it up there. That was their 17th attempt. They've made seven of them, though. Bulls are 1-for-11 after the first fake by Bermejo. Why not go for another one? And it ripped in! Front rim, high off the backboard, knocks in, finally, times two, and the Bulls have it to within two. Crowd responds to Christina Bermejo, 1:40 to go.
And this is what the coaching staff said they were seeing in Christina Bermejo all through practices.
What a big development, and she is, like you said, out on Beyonce B, their second leading scorer. Alvarez on Markson, nice pass over to the left wing, there's King. Boy, you know she wants to put it up from there, but Harvey jumps out on her, five on the shot clock. B travels, absolutely she did. That's great defense by Bermejo, who right now is the MVP of the Bulls. I think just for her minutes, but not to mention she makes a couple of threes.
And the two Christinas are very close, I understand. So you can see that they're enjoying having both being able to play on the floor at the same time and both performing well.
Bermejo from Spain and Brabinsova from the Czech Republic. And the Bulls unbelievably can tie or maybe take the lead. If this Alvarez three, nope, she fakes it. Oh, a nice drop off pass to Levert, drives the lane and gets fouled. Boy, this has been a tremendous run by the Bulls, a 6-0 run, both on three-pointers.
And this is Sydney Harvey playing the point here, right? So this frees up Alvarez to be a threat from the three-point line, which everyone has to go out on. That allows her to drive. It opens up the interior. She's such a great passer, right? So for Mayho now also creating another issue. So Idaho having to pay attention to a lot more, but really Harvey playing the point is what's helpful here because it frees up Alvarez.
Bulls were down by eight before the two made threes by Bermejo. Shea Leverett misses that free throw. Bulls still have been making a living at the line, although that was just their second attempt of the quarter. 11-14 on the game. Can Shea cut it to one with 1:09 to go? Looks short, and it is. And it'll be B with the rebound. That's all right. I mean, if you'd have told me, if you could keep it two at halftime, that'd be fine. The way this game has gone, Idaho up by 10 and 8 recently. But this is a big three by B. Oh, man, it looked like another bank shot maybe. But Bermejo gets the rebound, and she wants to run with it. A little bit out of control, but she gets it over to Sydney Harvey. So that's a big miss by Idaho, which has just all of a sudden cooled down and threes this quarter, 2-for-11. Big gap between the shot and the game. Harvey out to Brabinsova for the lead, and it's no good. But Shea Leverett battles for the board. Back out to Bermejo, who smartly gets it back out for a reset. We hit 30 seconds on the game clock in the half. Bulls down two. Again, they were down 10, and not too long ago, eight. Harvey, decent screen by Leverett over to Alvarez. Got to be careful not to shuffle the feet. Almost traveled underneath the basket. Reverse layup, no good. And Idaho can hold for the last shot, which would be the smart thing if you're the Vandals. No, they want to jack up a three. This is a big moment, and it's no good. Wow, what a break. They did not hold for the last shot. Now the Bulls with eight. Sydney Harvey takes it. They're down by two. She just wants to drive it on in. Out to Bermejo. Three, two, one at the horn. No good. Leverett actually put it in, but it was after the buzzer. So 33-31. Idaho has the lead at halftime. And frankly, all things said and done, I think they will take that position on the scoreboard. And we talked to Michelle Woods Baxter, who, boy, a lot to go over in that first half, Coach, but I'd say we'd have to start off with Christina Bermejo because that was fantastic.
Yeah, Chris has had a great week of practice, so it's good to see her come in and show in a game that, you know what, she was ready to play after the injuries.
And, Coach, how nice was it to have Sydney Harvey come back in, freeing up Alvarez to either shoot or create? It's got to be nice.
Yeah, it really is. We're going to play her, of course, limited minutes. but it is. It's nice to see her on the court. She wanted to be on the court, and she was ready.
And of course, they're known this year for their three-point defense, 0 for 11 until those two makes by Bermejo. But you're getting good looks still, right? Not going to go shy away from that part of the game today?
Yeah, we're getting good looks. You know, we had last game we had 17 of them, so hopefully this half we start hitting them again.
And Coach, talk to us about the defense. It looks like good rotation by the Bulls, but Idaho's still hitting some threes. Is it just the urgency to get out there, high hands, low bodies, or what's happening?
Yeah, a little bit. I think we're getting caught up on a couple screens, and I think we got to talk better and make sure we're going over top the screens and not going under and going through because they're shooting lights out right now.
Best of luck for a belated happy birthday present, Coach. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Michelle Woods-Baxter, whose birthday was just a few days ago, and talking about how the team performed here in the first half as down by two at the half, but they've been down a lot more than that. Idaho once led this game by 10 points. The Bulls a 6-0 run, specifically two made threes by Christina Bermejo, their first made threes of the day. At half, it's Idaho 33, USF 31. It's going to be a fun halftime with these superstars performing. I'm sorry, you put a big inflatable mascot with the name Dion Salamanders in front of me, and I'm laughing every time. And hopefully it's a fun second half. Who is that, Mia Hammer time?
Yeah.
Mia Ham, okay, all right. Mia Hamster, that makes even more sense.
Okay.
It's at the hamster. I'm really enjoying this. And Peyton Manatee with the Peyton Manning outfit. Superstars will get you every time. And the Bulls trailing at the break, but still very much in this game. We'll have some scores from elsewhere in college basketball. Let you know what's going on around the conference and the top 25. And sort of give you a little preview of what's to come next here in the doubleheader here on a Sunday with the men's squad in action as well. This is women's basketball and USF Bulls Unlimited presented by Marathon. Man, I feel like I was playing that half.
I do too. I feel exhausted.
Do salamanders have two heads?
No, I don't. Do they? I don't understand this. I'm so pumped. I mean, my children are loving this.
That was good. That was good.
That was good.
That was impressive.
I don't really want Coach, though, having that. We don't need him sick.
Kentucky up 9.5. Tulsa getting a battle from Stetson.
Really?
So which one eats the referee? I think it's Peyton Manatee.
Oh, you didn't get a halftime one, did you?
Oh, no. Look at this.
Oh, boy, it's going to be
there
a good song. Sorry. It's always funny.
Why is that always funny?
Well, Bulls finally got some shots to fall at the end of the first half. They still trail a Red Hart starting Idaho team 33-31. Coming up after this game, it'll be the men going up against Drexel trying to add another home victory as they start off, kind of like the Bulls, a big span of three games in less than a week's time. The Bulls will be playing a game in Houston against Utah State. That is a huge game for them. And they'll follow that up with a game in Sunrise against FSU. So a big, big part of the schedule for Brian Gregory's team, which is 5-4 on the season, coming off of a couple of nice home wins against Furman and Dartmouth. Of course, the big news on campus this week was Jeff Scott, the new head football coach, who I saw the other day, wanted to come to basketball practice and meet both coaches. Boy, has the response to him been tremendous.
Tremendous. Well, he deservedly so, right? Not only does he come in highly, highly qualified for this position, but he has endeared himself immediately to this community just through his opening press conference, but perhaps mostly through his daughter, Hannah, who has been a media sensation here. in Tampa. People love seeing her. She's always got her Rocky with her and her green bow, and she's very, very cute. And so, you know, it might be great that we have Jeff Scott, but it's probably really awesome that we have Hannah.
And we're going to see more players, I would guess, come on into the USF fold. Darian Felix, who was an original Oregon player that went out there when Willie Taggart left Oregon, he has committed to the Bulls as a transfer. So you're going to see a lot more of those additions, I think, here. And also this week, another new coach on the Bulls who's gotten some pub is Eric Jenkins, the new track and field coach. They announced a couple of transfers for the upcoming track and field season, which begins early January. So a lot of excitement around the two new coaches here on campus. Coming up, we'll let you know what's going on elsewhere around women's basketball on this Sunday and some of the keys from yesterday's action on always a busy weekend in college hoops. This is Women's Basketball on USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon. Ah, I like this. It's not just about being able to fool the game. You have to make a basket
nice.
First.
This girl's played some basketball at some point, at least little youth basketball.
Look at that. She knew she could slow down.
So I have to return at 1:30.
Yeah.
So one of the superstars' big things is that one of those big guys, they have a dummy referee, and he ends up eating him and spitting out his clothes.
Oh, that's funny. Oh, look at this girl one-handed. I see you, little girl. Yeah. Go.
She's going to win.
She needs to get her.
Gonna let her win. I see it now.
No. I don't think he's gonna let her win. Look at that. Go.
Hurry up.
Oh, she's not a good runner. Assists. Jeez.
Santa's looking a little creepy. Bulls trail at 33-31 at halftime to Idaho in a game they trailed by 10. First half stats coming your way with Bridget in a few minutes. Elsewhere, top 25 on this Sunday, NC State. Elon hung around. That's a below 500 team, but the Wolfpack stay undefeated, 62-49. Halftime, it's Kentucky undefeated against higher-ranked Louisville. You know, that's an intense game at Lexington, and the Wildcats lead it at the break, 40-31. Number 19, Michigan State just started off the second half on top of Morehead State, 47-19. Always good when a team that the Bulls played, you know, much less beat, that'd be VCU, has a good result. So we're pulling for them today, and they're beating a one-loss Old Dominion, 26-24. Conference, Tulsa having difficulties in DeLand to Stetson, losing 34-30 early in the second half. Conference yesterday, nice win for Cincinnati over Xavier, 85-78. Memphis with an impressive win against Arkansas State, a 19-0 run in the middle of that game. They lead at win at 78-50. And Wichita was actually beating a good Creighton team. I'm telling you, Wichita's good this year in the fourth quarter, but they just couldn't make a shot. And Creighton turned it on in the fourth to win 56-46. Coming into today, UConn is 8-0. Three teams were 6-4, the two that won yesterday, Cincy and Memphis. And the Bulls can actually, I know it's not conference record, but break out of that three-way tie for second if they can come back and win today. Wichita, though, because of that, dropped to 5-4. First half stats coming up next, and then we'll tip it off for the second. This is Women's Basketball on USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon. Need anything?
I'm going to eat some.
That's
of your
yours.
Cookie.
That's yours, yeah.
Okay. Oh, here. How about this? Black coffee.
What?
Black coffee. Awesome.
I think she needs like 6 cookies.
No, I do not need 6 cookies. I'm eating cookies like as if. Okay. Get rid of our gum here so that we don't welcome back to the Engling Center, where the Idaho Vandals lead the USF Bulls by 2, 33-31. This is Bridget Miranda with some quick halftime stats here. We'll start with some Iowa. Iowa's shooting about 38% from the field, 36% from the three-point line on 7-for-19 shooting. Kind of a surprise considering they're averaging about 25% there coming into the game. 100% from free throw line. Vandals being led in scoring by Isabel Haddon with 8 points. Ten assists for Idaho, so they're finding their players, probably why they're hitting their shots. Just 3 turnovers for the Vandals. In the rebounding category, of course, Bulls out-rebounding Idaho 31-17 with 15 offensive rebounds for the Bulls. Idaho being led in the rebounding category by Natalie Klinker with just 3. Bulls, on the other hand, 7 rebounds for Christina Berbenceva, doing a great job on the offensive and defensive glass, 4 offensive rebounds for her. In the points, Bulls being led by Shea Leverett and Christina Bermejo with 8 points each. 6 points, though, from Sydney Harvey, which is good to see her coming back this game. Bulls shooting about 25% from the field, 9-35. Just 15% from the three-point line, 2-for-13. Of course, Christina Bermejo hitting 2 of those on her 2-of-3 from the three-point line. Free throw percentage, good to see from the Bulls here, about 73%, 11-of-15. Points in the paint, Idaho leading that category surprisingly, or I'm sorry, excuse me, USF leading that category 10-2, so not surprising there. Second chance point, USF also leading that category 6-2. Points off the bench, 22 for USF to 17 for Idaho. Bulls 5 assists, so that's a number you'd like to see creep up in the second half, and of course turnovers, Bulls with just 6. Derek Sharp and I will have the second half when we return. This is Women's Basketball on USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon. Thank you.
All right,
thanks for the coffee.
No problem.
Well, not only is this photo my screensaver, but it got him in Etsy as a model.
Very photogenic. He should smile more.
I thought I saved it. Why wouldn't I? That's not it. Anyway. Oh, here we go.
That's a good.
My dog
like
is
a stuffed
a model.
Animal.
Well, if the second half is as eventful as the first, you're going to have a couple of out of breath, maybe out of voice announcers, because it was quite something, Bridget Miranda, because you go back to, you know, the two early foul trouble situations with Beatrice Jordal and Shea Leverett and, I'm sorry, Tamara Henshaw, and of course, being without your starting point guard, being without your big power forward, and yet still hanging around in a game where you were just getting vastly outshot. What a performance specifically by Sydney Harvey and Christine Bermejo to have the Bulls only down 2 as we start the second half. And B, their normal second leading scorer, comes in and misses a shot, but it'll still be Idaho ball, 20 on the shot clock.
The Bulls have a little bit of work to do. That was a better defensive possession, but B has turned out to be kind of a difficult matchup for them. I like still Berbenceva on her.
Ironically, she made her first shot of 3, and she's 0-for-6 since. But again, Idaho gets the ball back. The Klinkers are back out there, so B's going to go for 3, and she makes it. What do you know? Beyonce B gets Idaho back up 5, 36-31. So the Bulls find themselves in comeback mode, as they have been since the very beginning of this game. They were down 10 at one point, cut it to 2, had a couple of chances there at the end of the first half. Missed a couple free throws, as you recall. Ball was kicked there by Idaho as Tamara Henshaw tried to get it inside to Beatrice Jordal.
You know, I'm not sure why. I feel like they're still not going out with enough urgency on the shooters. I think the help side is there. They don't need to risk not getting help.
Harvey, incidentally, starting the second half. And I mentioned Bermejo's valuable contributions, and Harvey's got to mention Shea Leverett as well. Now, can Harvey make this three look short? And it is. Idaho with a good block out there, and it'll be Chase Milne. So starting lineup in for Idaho, same starting lineup for the Bulls, but with the big exception being Harvey for Chinecki. And Robbie out on B, who fakes the three that time. They get out to Markson. They got to watch her from out there. 1 minute gone in the second half. There's another long three, and it's short. That's a big miss right there. Robbie pulls it down. Alvarez has a chance to run it, but against a much taller player, she's going to drop it off to Sid Harvey, then post it back up for the return pass for a wide-open three, and it's just no good. But Tamara Henshaw battles for the board. She puts it down, gets fouled. Puts it up, I should say. Couldn't put it down, but she'll head to the free throw line.
Well, you know, this is got to think Alvarez is going to hit one of those two. She's coming off a really great game with 18 points in the last game against Alabama State, and she just hasn't quite found the range yet.
Bulls have three players that have tried multiple three-point attempts without making one yet. Nina Chinecki being 1-0 for 2 back into the game for Brobby. Already another substitution as, let's see, if that's the third foul on the bigger clinker, Natalie. Yes, it is. So a third foul is first player in the game with three fouls. Got to start making these free throws. That's a big one. Started off making them. I should really point that out as well, but they've hit a little bit of a slide. It's 36-32.
You know, Coach Fernandez talking to Brabenceva when she came out, talking to her about that defense on B, saying you've got to get out there. She's got to get out there.
Bulls make the two free throws. They are 13 of 17 on the game. They are back to within three. Chineke is out on B. And boy, they let Haddon open, and she has been a big factor today. 4 for 5 from the floor. Coming in, shooting less than 40%. Knocks it down, 38-33. Bulls catching Idaho on a hot shooting day. And they've been open shots, got to mention that. Oh, good entry pass from Alvarez. Jordan might have gotten away with a little bit of a push there, but she knocks it down, 38-35. Now defense is the big, big charge here by the coaching staff. As Haddon is another player again. Isabel Haddon, a senior from Boise, who has been pretty good today. Now she gets it and just throws it up there. This time misses it, but keeps the rebound available and knocks it to a teammate. And it's Lizzie Klinker. So that was all Isabel Haddon, even though she missed the shot. By the way, Haddon has 10 points, and that was her first rebound. They might even give it to her, but it was really her rebound because she tapped it out. 40-35 Idaho. Chinecki wants to drive in. That looked great. She throws it down for her first, actually her second make today. It's 40-37. So Idaho and the Bulls trading blows here to start off the second half.
The Bulls just need a defensive stop. My goodness, they haven't gotten a defensive stop this half yet.
Seems like it. 3 for 6, but on the misses, they've gotten the rebounds and scored anyway.
Oh,
just
boy.
The one empty possession. That's not going to be empty. It's a good look in by Haddon, who has taken over this game inside the B for an easy layup. It's 42-37.
Great recognition of a mismatch there. Chinecki on B, and that is a big mismatch, especially in the post.
Haddon there, sixth leading scorer. She has had the biggest impact lately on this game anyway. Bulls down by 5 again. They keep cutting it down, though, and getting baskets like that. Sydney Harvey, give her 8 points. Ties her with Bermejo and Leverett for the team lead. She's the only of those three out there right now. Starting to slow down a little bit, but and it looks like and she could come out, but 6:50 to go here in the third quarter. It's 42-39 Idaho. They go right inside the B. Mismatch, so Harvey helps out, and it's going to be a hell ball. It's going to be Bulls ball. That was great recognition by Harvey because they had about, 7 inches on the B versus Chinecki.
B made that infamous post mistake, if you will, bringing the ball below her waist.
And Sydney Harvey checks out, huffing and puffing, but doing some great work there to end her shift of 3 minutes and 17 seconds. She has played quite a bit here today.
Yeah. She needs to get ready to come back in. You know, she allows, like I said, she frees up Alvarez.
As you're saying that, she goes right to the front of the bench, as it were, next to Danny Hughes in the front seat. 6.5 minutes to go, third quarter. Bulls down within three, I should say. Ball knocked away. Bulls could tie it with the three. They haven't been tied since the very beginning of this game. In fact, they have never been tied since 0-0. Alvarez is going to go for two, though. Lane opens up. Ball does not fall down, and it'll be Idaho ball. Shea Leverett had position for the rebound, but it got knocked away. So it didn't end up touching anybody. So Idaho keeps the ball in a three-point lead.
You know, good look by Alvarez, but still a lot of dribbling, right? A lot of hesitation on the guard area right now.
Padgett's into the game, 0 for 8 so far. Maria Alvarez, 0 for 5. They're combined 0 for 8 on threes. So one of them needs to get it going here. Markson's already got it going. Now she's going to drive in. They get it out to Beaver. A good-looking three-point shot, and it misses. Tamara Henshaw pulls down the rebound. Maybe she was too open there. Bulls down three, six to go. Third quarter. Good hesitation. Dribble drive by Chenecki, and she lays it in. Elena Chenecki has gotten it going with two quick buckets. Now four Bulls with 8 points, and the margin is down to one.
Now for his great look there. Cross court to Chenecki on the break. Had Enna coming down, but I think she knew that Chenecki on that weak side was going to have a better drive.
As close as it's been since Idaho made its first shot of the game to make it 3-0. Idaho up by one. Clinker out to Haddon. You got to watch out for her. She hands it off to Marks, and good defense by Alvarez. Now Marks is going to drive. Another drive by Mill. And you don't expect her to score, and it rims out. Thankfully for the Bulls, Chase Mill. Now the Bulls, with the crowd going crazy here, ready to explode if they can take their first lead of the game. Alvarez with the defender on her back. 5:10 to go, third quarter. Now she's going to set it back up. Crowd really into this one.
They are really into it. I think they know the Bulls have to secure this victory. This is a critical game.
Five on the third quarter clock, 10 on the shot. Chenecki, a drive again, out to Alvarez, is going to try and drive herself. Oh, delivered underneath, and the Bulls lead. First time I've been able to say that all day. Great pass, it's 43-42.
How about that look by Alvarez and cut by Shea Levert. Good catch, up strong.
And Idaho calls a timeout. They don't know what to do, they're behind. We'll take a break with 4:44 to go in the third quarter. Bulls up 43-42. This is Women's Basketball and USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon. Look at Pinzon trying to get in there, and she's having to hop away. Be careful. I'm going to make sure I'm right on Bermejo's. Got it. Awfully kind of Idaho to miss some shots.
God.
Getting that complex about Haddon.
I know. You know, the Bulls have brought that out, though, in people this year who are not scorers suddenly have their career games.
Yeah, well, she averaged a half dozen her first
okay.
2 years.
I feel a little bit
better
about
that.
Started
off good this year, but then hadn't done anything since, basically. It has been quite a wild one here. Get all the latest USF clothing and gifts featuring the complete line of Adidas Coaches sideline gear. The USF bookstore opens 7 days a week on the USF campus. You can also shop online 24/7 at usouthfloridabookstore.com. Bulls just took their first lead of the game, 43-42, fitting on a basket by Shea Levert, who leads the way with 10 points.
And six rebounds from her two. Bulls still keeping up on the boards, out-rebounding the Vandals 35-21, which is a huge margin. Again, it's going to be important because shooting has been hard that the Bulls for the Bulls today. The Bulls actually go to that offensive glass, but good trends on the shooting line, right? First quarter, they shot 18%, Derek from the field. Second quarter, 31%, and now up around 63%.
Because of the three-point shooting and the fact that the Bulls lead, considering that the visitors from Idaho are 8-22, while the Bulls is 2-15, you figure points in the paint might be favoring the Bulls. How about 20-4 in that category?
And that's because Alvarez is in there and able to play the two in interior pass. So when Harvey's in there is when we're seeing a lot of interior passing to the Bulls post.
So it's Alvarez, Chenecki, Pajic, T and Shea underneath, Markson. With Alvarez on her, forcing a tough possession here. Markson wants to give it up in the corner to Klinkler, and it got knocks down. Lizzie Klinker, I should say. She is the shooter of the Klinker sisters, and she knocks that one down. Well worked by Idaho, 45-43. Gina Markson, you could tell, would rather shoot the ball, I'm sorry, pass the ball than shoot it, even though she's their leading scorer. She basically got most of her points in one game. That's going to be a foul called against Markson. And that is going to be just her second, checking out the foul situation. really as far as the underneath player, Natalie Klinker was three. No one else has more than two. And then on the Bulls side, Brabi and Jordal with two. And that's the media timeout. The Bulls will have it when we come back. 4:08 to go here in the third quarter. Now Idaho back on top, 45-43. This is women's basketball on USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon. A lot of people did wear their ugly sweaters.
I know. I like that.
Three of 14 on threes.
I know. Don't even talk to me.
Enough of that. Did Christopher make one? Yeah, that's the one that really hacks me off. She was 3 of 27. And our girls, who have combined for 48, which is about the same as their whole team, are 0 for. Back down 45-43 to Idaho, which is again 4-3. Bulls at 6-4. Derek Sharp, Bridget Miranda, this Idaho team under the leadership of John Newley, who took over back in 2008, a program that had just won four games the prior season. He came from their rival Idaho State and has gotten them to the postseason six times. In fact, the first time they got to the NCAA tournament under him was 2013. That school had not been since 1985. They were a member of the WAC then. They're in the Big Sky now, picked to finish second. And a team that had to replace its top two scorers. Michaela Ference averaged 23 a game last year. Taylor Pierce, 19. They were the Splash Sisters. Again, Pierce set a single season record of all of Division I for made three-pointers in a season with 154. And even though they've lost the Splash Sisters, they're seeing some unlikely replacements for them today. They're 9 of 23 on three-point shooting. They have two players who've made a three that had just made three each coming into today. And the Bulls, two players who've combined for 48 made threes. We're talking about Alvarez and Pahadzic are 0 for. So maybe one of them gets it going. They're both on the court right now. 4 minutes to go. Pahadzic had a look at an open three. Passes up over to Alvarez as we're speaking of him. Back to Pahadzic with five on the shot clock. Chinecki guarded well. Is going to drive with an open lane and lays it in. Ties the game. Chinecki, I don't know if she knew that was so close to cutting it the shot clock, but she still ties the game.
And good screen by the post, keeping her defender a step behind, so the post player for Idaho could not go and help and get on Chinecki there.
Bulls 6 of 9 from the floor in this quarter. Again, no three-point makes. Idaho's been making the threes, and Markson keeps it going. She puts up a long three like there was nothing to it. Her third make, and the Vandals go back up by three. Unbelievable. 48-45. With 3:20 to go.
You know, Alvarez got through that screen.
Yes, she
did. She got through it. She had a hand in her face.
It was a good shot. And a rare turnover by the Bulls. That is just their seventh and their first of this half, with Markson getting the steal. She also leads them in that category. Boy, you would hate to see another three here. They've got to stay out on Markson. 3 minutes to go, third quarter, after the Bulls have done all this fighting to get back in. Great cut. Great pass from Haddon. And it's a five-point game just like that as B puts it up and in. 50-45. And the Bulls are going to call timeout. So out of the media break, the Idaho Vandals get that huge three from Gina Markson, who was the freshman of the year in the Big Sky last year. And again, has been looking more to pass today. That was her third make in eight attempts, but they're all been from three-point land.
Yeah, and they've been long threes. So this is long threes and long threes pulling up with a defender either coming at her or with at least a hand in her face. You know, I think the Bulls, their rotation is so good on their defense. I think they should get out and almost face guard those three-point shooters and just be right up in them and see what happens. you know, see if they take you on a drive, if the help side is there, like I think it is, and if the rotation is there to drop by the far opposite wing or the weak side wing, because they're clearly a hand in the face is not bothering the three-point shooters for Idaho.
Markson is out there, so is B. Also coming back out into the game, Haley Christopher, they got to watch out for her. Isabel Hadney, 6'4 senior from Boise, has been a big factor tonight, is out there as well as the wing of the two Klinker sisters, Lizzie Klinker. Alvarez to Brabi into the game for the Bulls. Nice looking jumper and knocks it down. That's a big shot right there. Brabi's shot hasn't been falling tonight, but she had no hesitation there and gets it back down to three with 2.5 minutes to go in the third quarter.
And good to see her shoot and not look to pass first. She needs to look to shoot.
Off the bench, off the timeout, and her first make of the game. Now the Bulls, Alvarez face guarding Markson. That's a long three, and it's short. Surprised to see it miss. Ball is held up, though. It'll be Idaho ball, so the Bulls couldn't corral the rebound. They've been so good in that category. In fact, 16-5 on the offensive glass, and that was a held ball, not an offensive rebound. So 20 on the shot, 2:20 on the third quarter clock, and Idaho up 50-47.
This is a strange miss, too, from that part. Just hit and dead off the front of the rim there.
Bulls have made their last four field goal attempts. But, again, Idaho's had the answer here. And Markson wants to drive in. Out to Haddon. She has been a pain in there. You know what? But she misses that one. Haddon was 4-6. Back to a three-point game. Maria Alvarez at the point right now. Hesitation dribble against Markson. Out to Bermejo, who is back in the game. She's going to drive in. Lefty layup, and it rolls in. She's been getting the roll. She has been a big spark and is on a roll, and the ball's back to within one. What a game by Bermejo.
Wow, what a grand. What a great left hand.
Unreal. Markson with Alvarez on her. Two young, impressive point guards, but Markson has won the battle here today. Again, far from the basket, but Alvarez has to stay on her from out there. She's about 28 feet away. She's got to be ready for this one to go up with 8 on the shot clock. Markson hangs on to it. Off to Klinker. That's a hard jumper, and it rims out. And Henshaw flies in for the rebound. Bulls are going to hold it up. They briefly took the lead, only to have Idaho answer right back. The Vandals have been very good, not headed up by anything here today. Bulls took that 43-42 lead. And remember, Klinker responded with the three, and not long after that, it was Markson as well. It's been an impressive performance by the visitors, but the Bulls can retake the lead here. 1:10 to go in the third quarter. They want to go inside, but the Vandals are only 7. May have to put it up from outside. Alvarez hands it off to Henshaw, and now it's got to go up from Bermejo to shoot the ball. She does. Actually, if it hits the rim, could have. Oh, it almost banked in! But it's Idaho ball. That one almost banked in. I was going to say the Bulls have to be ready to get the ball if it hit rim, which it did, but it almost did more than that. 50 seconds to go in the third quarter. That would have been the shot of the year. Believe me, I've seen all the shots.
To take a lead, for sure.
That would have been the shot of the year. Idaho hangs on to its one-point lead. Haddon with Leverett far out on her. You got to stay out on her. Klinker gets the handoff, wants to drive. Brabi, good help defense, and it's a tough shot.
Yeah.
But it's put up and in by Klinker, Lizzie, that is, of the Klinker sisters. Now she has 12 points to actually take the team lead. Bulls can hold for the last shot here. There's a tenth of seconds difference between the shot and the game. It's 52-49, even though the scoreboard does not show it. Idaho got that basket, so it's a three-point deficit here for the Bulls. They will get the ball to start the second of the fourth quarter, so if they can score here, it would be great. Alvarez with 8. Out to Brabi, looks at the clock. Over to Leverett. Free throw. Dump to Henshaw. Can she lay it into the horn? Misses the layup, but she's fouled. So going to the line with 1.4 seconds left. Two big free throws coming up here.
And Henshaw doing a great job fighting for position there. When the ball swung back up to the top of the key, she was able to spin on her defender and have that wide open pass to her left hand, which is her strong side, and go up strong. Now these free throws are critically important right here. She's got to put these in.
Just the third foul called on either team in this quarter. In fact, none called on the Bulls. And Shaw's free throws have been good today, and she knocks that one down. Make it 6-7. The team is 14-18. Again, the Bulls are just 2-16 on threes. Idaho is 10-25. But free throws and rebounds, and they're hanging around. Missed that one, though. But Leverett almost got it at the buzzer, so it'll be Bulls ball to start the fourth quarter, and they're within two. Pretty even quarter, in fact, 19 apiece. Can the Bulls make some threes? Can Idaho miss some threes? That'll probably be a key among many things we look at when we head to the fourth. Next, this is women's basketball on USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon. Louisville.
Yes, sir. You guys know it is our holiday spectacular, and there's a lot of fantastic ugly sweaters here. But Clark Griswold right here, to me, I think is taking the cake. I wish I had a Moose Goblin full of eggnog for you, but sir, you're going to get hooked up with tickets to Enchant Christmas. The four of you guys are going to go to the facility down in St. Peter Tropicana Field. We're going to take care of these guys with four tickets because we're in the holiday spirit. So congratulations to you guys. But right now, we need you guys to make some noise for your
Buccaneers are killing the Lions. That's good.
Well, they're playing well, huh?
Yeah. It has been a battle and an impressive one here for the Bulls today, even though they trail Idaho 52-50 heading into the fourth quarter. They shot the ball about as well as you can in that third, just not making any from beyond the arc, and that's the difference today.
For sure, because Idaho is. They're 50% right now from beyond the arc. Another thing that's interesting, Bulls averaging over seven steals a game. Right now they only have one. Mm. And I don't really know the reason behind that because they do seem to be out on the three-point line, but it's almost as though if they could get in the passing lane a little bit more, they might be out there and have a better opportunity to get a hand in the face of the Idaho shooters and maybe distract them a little bit more. But still, great work by Chinecki with 10, great work by Shea Lever with 10 points, but you know they still got to outscore.
Idaho came into the day averaging a decently low number of committed turnovers per game. 15, that's not good. But really today, as you mentioned with the steals, just four committed. Of course, when you are getting shots early in possessions, which they have often today, and making a lot of them, you're not going to commit many turnovers. So the Vandals, 10 of 25 on three-pointers. The Bulls, 2 of 16, but they only trail it by two. And they start off this fourth quarter with the ball. Maria Alvarez running the point with Chinecki in this situation. Bermejo has been so good today. Wants to drive, but gets headed off. Out to Brabi, and then Shea Leverett completes the lineup. Brabi with a spin move. Tough shot. Leverett with a great positioning, though, and she puts it up and is fouled. Oh, I thought that was going to be an and one. So did she, but she will head to the free throw line.
Gosh.
And you can see the coach, John Newley, very upset at not the refs, the rebounding situation, which favors the Bulls by plus 16.
And Shea right now has 7 rebounds, 5 of those offensive.
Unbelievable. Offensive rebounds right now, 18-6, but the second chance points, just 8-7. These would add to that. Line drive three throw, that'll work. It goes down 52-51. Idaho, another staggering number. Again, when you only commit 4 turnovers, you're probably going to leave points off turnovers. That is 10-0 right now in favor of the Vandals. But we could have a tie game, and that rims out. Idaho will get the rebound. So we mentioned the Bulls lineup, have Markson out there. She's been tremendous. Beyonce B. And Haddon, who's been a key for them with 10 points. B has 10, and watch out for Klinker. And, of course, the three-point shooter into the game.
She walked.
I thought she did walk, talking about Caitlin Jones, and she gets off a three and deservedly misses it. That would have been a rough one to swallow right there for the Bulls by Caitlin Jones. They were ready for her to shoot that three. Chinecki drives in. Tough shot, and it rims out. Leverett tries to tap the ball inbounds but taps it out. So it'll be Idaho ball still. 9:09 to go in the fourth. Bulls trail it 52-51. Haddon comes out. In comes Natalie Klinker. She's the post player of the two. She's been in foul trouble all day long. The Bulls got to be mindful of her. But it's her sister, Lizzie, the wing, who has 12 points again. 2 of 2 on threes. Markson's been the marksman with 3, and the Bulls got to keep an eye on her. Idaho's been on B. Out to Young. They got to watch her. Now she's going to drive in for a rare 2, and she sinks it. Player who is not used to firing it up from two-point range, and she puts up the Vandals by 3. Get this, 36 shot attempts coming into today, 26 were from 3.
Whew.
So they didn't see that coming. 54-51. Bulls had a chance to take the lead last time, couldn't convert. Chenecki had a good shot out to Bermejo, who's made a couple of threes, but she drags her pivot foot, and the Bulls turn it over. Hesitated a little bit, and the crowd didn't like it, but that's been a consistent call from the officials today.
That has been a consistent call from the officials and a consistent call on Bermejo. She has had that travel call with the dragging the foot many times this year.
Eight turnovers is all that the Bulls have committed, but that comes at a poor time. Everything, every little thing right now becomes a big thing. 8.5 minutes to go. Bulls down by three after Young with a surprising shot. Now they, I thought that was a clean block on Haley Christopher, and I'm not so sure she was shooting the ball there, but she is going to get a trip to the free throw line where Idaho has only been once today.
Yeah, that's surprising, huh?
Two for two.
I guess they've hit just a bunch of three-point shots.
Yeah, we're right not hard to disagree with the call too hard when it's the first foul called against the Bulls this half. 8:24 to go in it. 54-51 Idaho. Christopher at the line. That ball hung up there forever. And it goes down. Man, just 3 of 6 on the season so far. They are a 61% shooting team from the line. Not good. This should not be good as a result. And of course it goes in. 56-51. Every time it looks like the Bulls are ready to get some sort of control of the game, it just does not happen. Gotta credit the Vandals for that, but you gotta feel like the Bulls are just a couple of big three makes away from changing the narrative. Robbie far away from the basket with Young out on her. I'm sorry, Jones out on her, doing a good job. Markson on Chenecki, gets a decent screen from Bermejo. You know it's got to go up here. No spin on that ball, and it's no good, but Brabi gets the rebound. Back out to Bermejo. Alvarez with 15 on the shot clock. Chenecki with Markson on her. Looks for a screen, gets it. Long jumper, and it's no good, but Brabi flies in for the rebound. Could have gone up with it, but Alvarez gets it instead.
Four freshmen on the floor right now, Derek, yeah, for the Bulls. So.
And Shea Leverett, the only non-freshman, of course, the redshirt junior. Alvarez wants to drive in, and she gets blocked on the way to the basket. She's going to take a tumble, courtesy of Natalie Klinker. New 20 on the shot clock, 7:39 to go, and the Bulls off to a struggling start here if they miss their first four shots in the fourth, and they trail at 56-51.
And I think we're probably about 2 minutes away from seeing Harvey come in to finish the game. I think she'll come in and let Alvarez get some relief from point, let her move to a two.
Robbie drives out to Alvarez for a big three, and it's good! Maria Alvarez was 0-for-3 from distance, and she cuts it to two, 56-54. That is more like it. Crowd on its feet, bench on its feet. Jose Fernandez near midcourt.
The crowd was very tense, weren't they? It's like they were waiting to make sure the Bulls scored.
Alvarez out on Markson, and they force her to cough it up. Christopher drives, they cut her off. Good job. Markson has the ball with 10. On the shot clock. Boy, they want to get it out to Jones for the three.
Woo!
It's going up, and she misses it. But Idaho gets the rebound. Knocked away by Bermejo, but it'll be Idaho ball out of bounds. So they finally get a miss. It just seems like the Vandals have had the knack to make that shot at every turn. I can't believe they're just 10 for 27. It seems like they've made more of a percentage than that on threes. But the Bulls just got a big one, and even though they're only 3 of 18, yet that down to a two-point lead. Markson, she's been so good. Again, reigning Big Sky Freshman of the Year, hands it off to B. Has been tremendous as a freshman for them. Those are the two best players to get it to Klinker, and she's not going to score from out there. Now to B, five. Leverett jumps out on her, gets a hand on the ball, and it's a turnover forced by the Bulls, thanks to Shea Leverett. 6:40 to go, fourth quarter. Jose Fernandez wants to call a play here. I think it's going to end up back in Alvarez's hands based on her maybe the point. Grabby runs underneath the curl, but Alvarez keeps it. Bulls definitely want to get Maria as the focal point of this set. Now back to Chenecki with 10. On the shot clock, Bulls down two. Out to Brabi for a three. Ends up and off the rim, and it'll be Idaho ball. Boy, that ball had some nice rotation on it. Now Idaho wants to run. You got to watch Markson. And she is going to be called, actually, Alvarez for fouling Markson. That's just the second foul of the quarter on the Bulls, so two on each team. 6:09 to go, Idaho up 56-54. Bulls were down 10 early in this game. Got it to two at half. Took a couple of brief leads, but Idaho has had to answer every time. Vandals with some balanced scoring. Same goes for the Bulls. 56-54. Ooh, good inbounds pass, but a bad shot. I don't know how it was missed so badly by Klinker, but we'll take it. Team that's shooting pretty well today. Ooh, Alvarez wanted to take a quick shot out of that set. Would have given the Bulls the lead if it had gone down, but she pulls it back, guarded by Christopher. Size disadvantage Bulls in this situation. Henshaw bounce pass into Leverett. A tough dribble, and she gets fouled on the way to the hoop. She was hoping for a foul call there. Was going to be her only hope of getting some points here. She will go back to the free throw line.
And a good post-up, duck in, post-up by Leverett when Tamir Henshaw had the ball at the top of the key. Henshaw and
is going to be a fifth foul.
Really?
On Natalie Klinker. She is just, this is her 18th minute, and that's going to be her last minute. So while they're waiting to see who comes in for her, it'll be Haddon, who scored 10 points and really has been the better player today. She's been a valuable player for the Vandals, who lead by two. Leverett looking to cut into the lead. 3 of 7 from the free throw line today. After these two attempts, that one is good, cuts it to a 1-point lead. She will have gone past the halfway mark of how many attempts from the line she's had all year. So again, Jose Fernandez trying to get that part of the game improved. The Bulls have been to the line 22 times. This is about to be number 23 compared to 4 for Idaho. And it's good! She makes them both, and it's a tie game again, 56 apiece with 5:48 to go. Crowd getting behind the team here. That's 11 points for Henshaw, 11 rebounds for Henshaw, 10 for Bravi. Great performances all the way around. And oh no, you heard it. As an open three by Caitlin Jones, the Australian freshman, and that is her only game, basically. She now has 11 points to lead the way, actually one shy of the team lead. On that end, it's back to a 3-point margin that the Bulls face. They want to go inside, and it gets away
really
from Leverett.
Pass.
And it was a tough call there. 5:15 to go. Jones, you know,
get
she wants to
her.
Pull up. That's a long three. Boy, that was a good-looking shot, but missed it. Anipa Hadgetts pulls down the rebound with some force. Bulls want to run the other way. Hadgetts wants to drive with 5 minutes to go in the game, unless we go beyond. It's 59-56. So Caitlin Jones, 3 of 9 on threes. Again, shoots about 80% of her shots from beyond the arc. She made a big one there. Leverett far away from the basket, 10 seconds on the shot. Pahadges hasn't made one yet today, and she still hasn't made it. A little bit long. Great effort by the Bulls. Does Bravi go up with it? No, she forces it back out to Alvarez. That was a poised move there by Bravi, and another offensive rebound. If the Bulls win the game, that will be the reason why. 20-7 on offensive rebounds. 4.5 to go in the game. They're down by 3. Alvarez dribbles it out to Pahadges. Passes on the open three and puts up a short shot, and just no good. She doesn't have the confidence in her shot, unfortunately. 0-10. Okay, now I run the other way, and B's going to go right down the lane and lay it in. Great basket by B, and it's a 61-56 Idaho lead. So got to give credit to the Vandals. Every single time the Bulls get close, they score. And now the Bulls need a timeout. With 4:06 to go, they're down by 5. This is women's basketball on USF Bulls Unlimited, presented by Marathon. Hadgetts struggling, darn it. Goodness.
Ugh. I feel tired, don't you?
Yeah, me too.
Hey, you know who we're missing? Shepta.
We're not done yet, because it is time to shake it off with a man rocking Eagle. We have free milkshakes from Chick-fil-A for those that are shaking it in the stands right now. Rocky is looking for you. If you are shaking it off, we're going to hook you up with a shake. I don't see anybody shaking it right now.
When traveling to see the USF Bulls, start with a fill-up at Marathon. And to make it a winning trip, go to milesavmeaning.com. Marathon, fueling the American spirit. Well, after a great shooting performance in the third quarter that had the Bulls staying even with a red-hot shooting Idaho team, not going so well here in the fourth, and they trail at 61-56 with 4:06 left.
Bulls shooting 12.5% in the field right now and 25% from the three-point line. Idaho, on the other hand, shooting around 43% from the field and about 38% from the three-point line. It's honestly surprising it's this close because those numbers are not good for the Bulls. And Pahedzic having just a very difficult shooting game right now, 0-for-10. Bulls still doing a great job on the boards, though, out-rebounding Idaho 45-28. But, you know, four players on Idaho are in double digits right now, and that is a surprise.
There's the last quick five on the made three and the B layup. That was their first fast break basket, up by five. Bulls were down 10, took a brief lead, only to have the Vandals respond with two quick threes. And after the Bulls tied it, Idaho scored the last five. Maria Alves had a big three before. This would be a big one as well, and it rims in! I thought that was going to bounce out. Huge shot by Maria. Two big back-to-back. What a shot.
What a shot, and it willed itself into that basket. It was not a dead-on look.
Fifth player with at least 8 points. She's right on that number. Bulls have got to be careful. And B wants to drive in on Brock. Marks and far away from the basket. Three on the shot clock. B has to put up a tough shot. And a foul. Unbelievable. A desperation shot by Haddon. Misses. But this could be Idaho's day because Klinker, with one motion, catches it, shoots it in, and is fouled. Looks for a three-point play.
Yeah, Bulls, great urgency on the possession. I mean, they were there.
And I think they just sort of eased up for a second because they played such good defense to force that shot, and it's a three-point play. Give Klinker credit. She is a senior wing transfer from Utah State with three big points there, 64-59. Goodness. Now Sydney Harvey back in. She's giving the Bulls some good minutes today. Out to Brabby, and she travels. Christina Robinsova travels. 3:11 to go, and the Bulls are in trouble. 64-59. Boy, what a great defensive possession. And they force a tough shot from Haddon, and she basically bricked it up there. But Klinker gets the rebound.
Yeah, Bulls didn't finish the possession, right? They thought the shot clock had gone off. They just didn't finish that possession, so didn't have the blockout that we're used to seeing.
21-8, offensive rebounds favoring the Bulls, but that was the biggest one of the game for Idaho, which is going to run some clock here smartly with 3 minutes to go, and it's a five-point lead. Haddon wanted to crank it up, and now Jones is even so smart that she's not going to shoot it from where she normally would have. Good entry pass, I thought maybe out on the Vandals, but it's going to be Idaho ball. 11 on the shot, 2:51 on the game. Huge defensive possession here for the Bulls. And they are down by five, 64-59. Again, Idaho's just uncanny, and it's not been one person. Inbounds pass to Jones, and it goes long, and Leverett has to battle for the rebound and win it to Maria Alvarez. Now they want to run. Chinecki against a much taller player is going to drive in and turn it over. Good defense by B. Unbelievable. Chinecki sort of just fell to the turf and wanted to pass it out. Wasn't sure if she was going to shoot it. And B just sort of let her come at her, and it's a turnover by the Bulls. 2:39 to go. Bulls down five.
Bulls still trying to get it up the floor quickly. They need to do that, but they really need this stop right here.
It's Markson setting up on the right side. Haddon's going to take a really strange-looking three with lots of time on the shot clock. That is a big-time break.
Ill-advised.
Of course, if it goes down, it ends the game, but it's a break instead. 2:15. Now the Bulls setting up. They want to run a play here, I'm guessing, for Maria Alvarez. Chinecki running the point. Leverett gets her a screen. Chinecki puts up the long ball, and it's no good, but Maria flies in for the rebound, knocks it off of an Idaho player, so Bulls ball underneath the basket. 2:07 to go. In the fourth, Bulls still down five. Just 2 for 10 in this quarter, both Maria threes.
And after this play, Derek, the Bulls have seen this. You saw this in Cancun, this shooting. It's very strange to me.
They whip it inside to Leverett. That's the fourth foul of the quarter, so it'll still be possession for the Bulls. The Bulls will be shooting the next foul the rest of the way in these last 2:01.
Because they've had great looks. Cancun, this kind of just not being able
to get 20 back on the shot clock. Not that the Bulls are interested in running shot clock here. And Cancun, though, was the other team driving to the basket to get him.
She knocks it down. Maria Alvarez picking a good time to get in Fuego. And the Bulls still down two. 1:50 to go here. Crab on its feet. 1:50. And the Bulls down 64-62. They hand it off to Klinker. Markson sets up on the right side. You got to watch out for her. Haddon far away from the basket. It's kicked by Leverett. That could put five back on the mistake. It would go back to 15. 1:39 left in the fourth.
And now the height difference between Chinecki and Klinker. They are running Klinker down to the post, having her spin and post on Chinecki. That's difficult. A difficult matchup for Chinecki in the post. So we've got to watch that.
To Markson, far away from the basket with eight on the shot clock. B about.
Oh, it's not. 4:60. You know, Alvarez wanted to shoot it, but Idaho got out on her this time. So the Bulls have only three shots in this quarter. All threes by Alvarez. What a time to get it going. Bulls down by two. Alvarez off the screen, pops open. It's going up for the lead. Ah! 65-64, Maria Alvarez with the quarter of all quarters for the freshman. Idaho wants to keep the ball here without calling a timeout. There's the timeout. Listen to the crowd. I really want to listen to the crowd so I can save my voice because this is just unbelievable. I mean, Maria has put on some shows and we know she can do it, but I don't think in such a clutch situation until now.
No, what's the importance of Sydney Harvey though? You know, Sydney Harvey allowing Alvarez to go to that two is just really, really important for the Bulls. And credit the freshman hitting some big-time shots, just taking her shots. One thing for Bulls listeners, her parents are always at these games, and they're here, and they sit so calmly. They just sit. They cheer.
Did you see them? Were they calm that time?
Their daughter perform and perform. Getting Alvarez the ball, Alvarez getting her shot off, getting her feet set, and doing a really nice job at getting her shoulders squared.
Taking the lead or tied it up, Idaho has scored the next time down, or cut it to one for that matter. Now let's see what happens. 30 seconds difference, 15 on the shot, 48 on the game, and that's a foul drawn by the Bulls. Tamara Henshaw gets decked. You heard it. Finally, that will be Bulls ball. 48 seconds left. The Bulls may choose to advance here. No, they can't because it wasn't a scored basket. Idaho choosing not to pick up full court defense here, by the way. So this is a big possession. 47.8 seconds. Let's see what the Bulls call here. They pick it up full court. Sydney Harvey dribbles it across. Maria Alvarez, four made threes. She has 14 points. And now let's see if they feed her. Any basket would be big here because the Bulls are up by one. Seven. On the shot, 33 on the game. Harvey far away from the basket. Jose Fernandez barking out signals. Klinker on Harvey. 10 seconds. She wants to drive in, and she scoops it up. Oh, gets her shot rejected. That was a great job there by the 5'10 Lizzie Klinker. 20 seconds left. There was no shot clock here, so Idaho can hold for the last. They will take a timeout. What a block. I mean, what a block by Lizzie Klinker, the senior from Fairfield, Montana.
Really good defense by Idaho in a critical possession. How about, hey, you got two blocks on the season, but let's make probably the most important block so far of the season.
And you don't mind that move by Harvey. It was a good shot. It wasn't you're going up against a 5'10 play. You think you're pretty safe to get it up, but I'm looking at her career blocks totals to see if she had much in that category. No, not really. That was a big defensive play. Well, nothing like sweating out the end, which is what we're about to do.
Bulls are going to have to, I don't even know. They have to play great defense. They've got to get a hand in the face.
Both teams have one timeout. Idaho, I mean, you know their head coach, a veteran, John Newley, was going to call that timeout again. He knows what he's doing on programs, wherever he's been. So if you're the Bulls, I don't even know if you can think. You know that Idaho has been playing defense against Maria Alvarez these last four or five possessions, but who can you predict is going to get the shot for Idaho?
I don't know. They have all. There's four players in double figures. And they've all kind of hit above their marks, right?
Well, Klinker's the one who has 15 points and has made the two threes. Of course, they're going to go for any shot. I wouldn't be surprised if Markson takes the ball, looks for Klinker off the screen.
Yeah, and I know that Chinecki's not in the game. Bermejo is probably in part because of her size and length and to not allow a guard to go down and post up.
Allison Kirby in the game for a rare time, so the Bulls have got to watch out for her. And oh, Markson gets the ball. Bermejo far away. Harvey almost knocks it away. Back to Kirby. Markson long away from the basket. He's going to try three. It looks way off. I think it was deflected by Bermejo. Rebound Bulls. And Shea Lifford stepped out of bounds. 9 seconds to go. I think she was anticipating the foul and stepped out of bounds. Both teams have a timeout. Jose Fernandez thought that the Bulls are saying that Shea Leverett was calling timeout. Now, they can they look at that? That's what I'd be very curious about here. If the Bulls are claiming and Idaho actually calls timeout, but I don't think that's something you could replay. Either way, it's going to be, yeah, and Shea Leverett saying that she was trying to call a timeout there. So Idaho does call a timeout. It's last. Bulls still up by one with a 30-second timeout. 9 seconds left in the game here. Very disappointing. And was it Shea that got, no, it was Bermejo who got the deflection there on the long Markson three. So that answered our question, who they were going to look at. Their reigning freshman of the year in the conference, Gina Markson. What a game it's been. Bulls leader.
Down low, let her post up a guard and see if she can get off a two-point shot, not, you know, walking off the floor.
Important non-timeout call there by Jose Fernandez, who jumps out on the floor to give one last bit of instruction, because if Idaho does score here, that timeout allows the Bulls to move the ball up the court. They will inbound it with Kirby. Bulls up by one. They've been fighting uphill all game long. They just took the lead. Can they win it? Boy, they want to get it to Markson. Kirby throws it into Markson, far away from the basket. Long three. It's off the mark, but B kick at the rebound. Boy, it was right in front of her to be had, and her legs just couldn't quite carry her there. It's Bulls ball, 4.7 seconds left. Jose Fernandez is asking if he can advance the ball here, I think. He is going to call a timeout. So, and he's telling the ref where he wants the ball, basically in front of his basket. That was the conversation. So Markson, it looked off, but you never knew until it bounced off the rim, and I thought B had a clean line at that rebound.
Oh, so did I. It was very, that was not a good box out by the Bulls, first of all. So the Bulls lucked out that B didn't go get that. She had the ability to go get that, and what, you know, she's a really good player. She's had a really good game. So Bulls very lucky there. Chinecki now checking in to get in the game. You want another shooter in there, so another ball handler in there, and Chinecki definitely is that. Coach Fernandez, of course, advancing the ball in that timeout. You get to pick your side. Also, that's a new rule from last year. Pick your side of the court. So he's taking his bench side smartly so he can communicate with them while they're taking the ball out.
4.7 seconds left. Now, no more timeouts, and that's very important because, you know, Idaho will have to, normally in a situation after the Bulls, they'll have to foul. Whatever happens at the free throw line, Idaho would normally want to move the ball up. They will not be able to do that now, and that's a big, big factor.
That is a big factor, you know, but I can't
fault Idaho.
You know
what, as I'm saying that, let me look. Our official stats, the scoreboard here says no timeouts for either team. Okay, and the referee is just confirming because the stat service says there's one for Idaho. She just confirmed that neither team has a timeout. That's a big factor here.
That is huge. Now, Idaho, I think, had to take the timeouts that they did take, so I don't fault that at all. You're very, you know, great coaching by Idaho on that. But this is going to be a really interesting call. I think
now,
he's going to want it to get in Harvey's hands.
Idaho has to play man-to-man tough defense here. Do you get cute if you're the Bulls? Do you run some back in the backcourt and throw it back there, or you just get it in bounds quickly to your best free throw shooter, which at this point I'm guessing is Sydney Harvey. Tamara Henshaw will throw it in bounds. 4.7 seconds left. Bulls down by one. No one's getting to the ball. They got to throw it in. It's a bounce pass to Chinecki, and she almost traveled. In fact, they are fortunate right there because she took a step anticipating the foul. 7/10 of a second ran off the clock. It's 4 seconds left with Chinecki, a great three-point shooter, a free throw shooter at the line.
It's a hard game to call, but that was a dangerous.
I think obviously if you're Chinecki here, you just don't get cute. You try and make them both. 65-64.
Make them both.
Everyone's trying to figure out the timeout situation here, by the way. No Bulls in the paint. Free throw's good. 66-64. Still no Bulls in the paint. Now you have three Idaho players down there. Sydney's Harvey sort of hanging around. Chinecki makes the first free throw at 66-64. Bulls exactly 4 seconds to go. Make this one just so any sort of half-court drama doesn't lose the game for you. Free throw is up, and it's good.
Good job by the freshman.
And now here comes the long inbounds pass, 67-64. Idaho is going to fling it down the court. There's a pass and a handoff, and the Bulls foul at midcourt. They had a foul to give.
They had a foul to give.
Very smart. 3.1 seconds left. And basically it was a great conceived play by Idaho. 3.1 seconds left. They can't foul again. They could if they wanted to. They can if they want to force them to the free throw line. It's a three-point game, 3.1 seconds left. The Bulls look like they want to foul. They're playing tight defense, far away from the basket.
Oh, no.
Into the corner for an open three at the horn, and it banks out. Sorry, I hit the PA guy in the head by mistake because that was so dramatic. Markson gets the open look and missed it. So of all things, waiting until the end to miss a shot does Idaho, while the Bulls waited until the fourth quarter to make all their threes, namely Maria Alvarez doing the trick. And what a gutted out victory, 67-64.
And the freshman and Sydney Harvey, really Alvarez hitting those shots, Sydney Harvey coming in minutes, the post players staying with it, getting rebounds, and then Chinecki making critical free throws at critical times. So the freshman performing once again for the Bulls. Derek, an important when you don't shoot well.
Bulls were down five with less than 4 minutes to go. Maria Alvarez made three three-pointers of her four in the quarter and was the reason they won this game. We'll come back for the post-game show next and hear from Jose Fernandez. This is Women's Basketball on USF Bulls Unlimited presented by Marathon. Yeah. No, I don't think we're going out here. I think we're here.